morning is morning prayer number 2, you'll find that on page 101 of our prayer book. And I'd also like to welcome anyone who's watching our service via the internet. The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Worship the Lord in the beauty of holiness. Let the whole earth stand in awe. Our opening hymn this morning is hymn number 370.
Come, let us sing out to the Lord, let us shout to Him.
is Psalm number 146. You'll find it on page 761 of the prayer book. So that's Psalm 146, page 761. And we will read it in alternate half verse. Alleluia, praise the Lord, O my soul. As long as I have any being,
I have seen graces in my God.
Put not your trust in princes, nor in any human power. When their breath goes forth, they return to the earth.
On that day, all their gods perish.
Happier are those who have the God of Jacob for their help. Who made heaven and earth, the sea and all that is in them.
Who keeps his promise forever.
Who gives justice to those that suffer wrong.
And bring to those who hunger.
The Lord loses those that are bound.
The Lord opens the eyes of the blind.
The Lord lifts up those who are bowed down. Stranger in the land, he upholds the orphan and widow. The Lord shall reign forever. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit.
As it was in the beginning, is now, and shall be forever. Amen.
Please be seated for our first day. First reading is from the letter to the Hebrews, chapter 9, beginning at verse 11. But when Christ came as a high priest of the good things that have come, then through the greater and perfect tent, not made with hands, that is, not of this creation, he entered once for all into the holy place, not with the blood of goats and calves, but with his own blood, thus obtaining eternal redemption. For if the blood of goats and bulls, with the sprinkling of the ashes of a heifer, sanctifies those who have been defiled, so that their flesh is purified, how much more will the blood of Christ, who through the eternal Spirit offered himself without blemish to God, purify our conscience from dead works to worship the living God. This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
We now read together the words of the Te Deum on page 106. We praise you, O God. We acclaim you as the Lord. All creation worships you, the Father everlasting. To you, all angels, all the powers of heaven, the cherubim and seraphim, sing in endless praise. Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of power and might, heaven and earth are full of your glory. The glorious company of apostles praise you. The noble fellowship of prophets praise you.
Christ of your blood, and bring us with your saints to glory.
Keep us today, Lord, from all sin. Have mercy on us, Lord, have mercy. Lord, show us your love and mercy, for we believe our trust in you. In you, Lord, is our hope. Let us never be put to shame. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit. need,
and grant our brethren wisdom.
Let your ministers be clothed with righteousness,
and let your servants shine for joy.
O Lord, save the people,
and bless those you have chosen.
Give peace in our time, O Lord,
and let your glory be over all the earth.
O God, maintain our hearts within us,
and renew us by your Holy Spirit.
We call it the fourth Sunday before Advent. Almighty and eternal God, you have kindled the flame of love in the hearts of the saints. Grant to us the same faith and power of love, that as we rejoice in their triumphs, we may be sustained by the example and fellowship through Jesus Christ our Lord.
Amen.
God, the author of peace and lover of concord, to know you is eternal life, and to serve you is perfect freedom. Defend us in all the souls of our enemies, that we should, trusting in your protection, may not fear the power of the adversaries, through Jesus Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Lord, our Heavenly Father, Almighty and ever-living God, we give you thanks for bringing us safely to this day. Keep us from falling into sin or running into danger, and in all things, guide us to know and do your will. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord.
Amen.
And we continue in prayer. Heavenly Father, we give our lives to you, our minds with all strengthening, our heart with all its loving, our strength with all its working, our soul and all its worshipping. We give ourselves to you and seek to serve you and our neighbor. Through Jesus Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Lord God, let it be seen that we have been with you. Let there be places of glory in our lives. Fill with your radiance all who lead worship, all who preach and teach, and all who reach out through their missionary work. Father, we pray for the whole family of the Church here in Ireland, and ask that you direct and guide our Archbishop John McDowell and all those who work under his authority. May they all be built up in faith and demonstrate in their lives the gospel news. Through Jesus Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
God of peace, we thank you for your world, and remember that you entrusted it to our care as stewards. Give us wisdom to properly manage monies and personal finances, and to practice kindness and generosity to our neighbor. As we live each day, help us to treat our world fairly whilst accepting its goodness gratefully. Help us to remember that you are the giver of all that we have, and help us to put aside pride and ownership. Through Jesus Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
God of justice, keep us from being preoccupied with money and worldly possessions, and with trying to increase them at the expense of justice. Let's not be so concerned with our own problems that we become lacking in concern for the problems of others. Help us to demonstrate our love for you in our daily lives. Make us quick to forgive and slow to condemn others. Enable us to strive for peace in our own families, in our community, and the world in which we live. Through Jesus Christ our Lord.
Amen. Amen.
Father, we give thanks for all who serve others in your work. We pray for workers in agriculture, industry, and commerce. We pray for all for services. We pray for social workers. We pray for Samaritans and all who seek to be good neighbours. Give us a true awareness that we all share your world with others and help us make our homes and community welcoming places that reflect our Christian beliefs through Jesus Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Lord, hear our prayer. Loving God, we pray for any in our neighborhood who are lonely or who are feeling neglected or rejected. We give you thanks for our homes and our loved ones. Help us to play our part in helping and supporting those less fortunate than ourselves. Lord, bless all who are in illness and pain at this time. Be silently kneel them in our prayers. In your great goodness and mercy, Lord, grant them health of body, soundness of mind, hope of recovery, and peace of heart, that in wholeness of being they may glorify your name through our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. Amen. Lord, we welcome into the kingdom all who have searched for you and all who have served you. We pray for friends and loved ones departed. Help us all to live always mindful of your promise to us that the road of faith will lead into your heavenly kingdom through Jesus Christ our Lord. Through these prayers we offer afresh our lives as well as our words. Send us out into the world determined that each moment from now on becomes an offering of love for you. This we ask in Jesus' name.
Amen.
We conclude our prayers and sing together for this. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit, be with us all. the following address has been prepared by a rector, the Reverend Alan Sinnott, and as parish leader, it is my privilege to meet with you today. In fact, it's a great privilege to be here today. Anne Sinnott, the rector's wife, was scheduled to lead the service today, but having come home from holidays, she was a little unwell, and he'd asked me to step in, and I'm more than happy to do so. We commence this sermon of the short prayer. Open our ears, O Lord, to hear your word and know your voice. Speak to our hearts and strengthen our wills, that we may serve you today, now and always. Amen. The sermon this morning is based on the gospel reading which I read earlier. That was Mark chapter 12, verses 28 to 34. This week's text is the climax of a day of confrontation between Jesus and religious authorities in Jerusalem. However, just in case we're writing off all religious elites as hard-hearted and unseeing opponents of Jesus, Mark ends the series of hostile questions with a scribe asking a genuine question. This is a narrator, Mark, who tells us that the scribe had been positively impressed with Jesus, seeing that Jesus answered them well. We, the readers, should not gloss over this remarkable assessment of Jesus' honour by one of his opponents. The question the scribe asks, which commandment is the greatest of all? It's similar to the one asked by the rich young man in Mark 10, verse 17, which reads, as he was setting out on a journey, a man went up and knelt before him and asked him, good teacher, what must I do to inherit eternal life? The concern here behind the question is, how to lead a life of moral integrity? Concern that can only be answered by thorough and wise understanding and a practical application of the Old Testament law. We can tell that Jesus knows the question is genuine and not hostile, because he immediately gives a genuine and non-hostile response. Jesus simply and quickly is demonstrating his thorough knowledge of the wisdom about the Torah, quotes and links Deuteronomy chapter 6, verse 5, and Leviticus chapter 19, verse 18. The scribe continues the genuine dialogue by affirming and elaborating Jesus' reply. The scribe then says out loud the unspoken implication of Jesus, linking love of God and love of neighbor as oneself. No one in the crowd of both opponents and admirers would dispute love of God as the greatest commandment. But when Jesus goes on and links it to love of neighbor as oneself, he has lifted attachment to the welfare of one's neighbours above all other duties and obligations, including religious ones. This, of course, is reflected elsewhere when Jesus is speaking on the same matter. He clearly shows in the parable of the Good Samaritan that the religiously observant are those who pass by on the other side. Since Jesus is saying this while standing in the courtyard of the temple, just days before Passover, one of the most obvious implications would be, as the scribe himself says, to love one's neighbor as oneself. This is much more important than all whole burnt offerings and sacrifices. Tribe doesn't just say more important. He says much more important. The unnamed scribe has just said that the source of his livelihood is much less important than attending to the well-being of our neighbours. Notice that, like the rich young man in Mark 10, verse 17, Jesus sees the scribe as having answered wisely. But unlike the rich young man, Jesus does not ask him to give up his occupation, nor does he ask him to follow him. Instead, Jesus publicly honors the scribe with a word of praise. You are not far from the kingdom of God, which of course is an indication of the fulfillment of Jesus' original mission to proclaim. The time is fulfilled and the kingdom of God has come here. We need those words in Mark chapter 1, verse 15. Here, at the peak of confrontation between Jesus and the religious elites of Jerusalem, it was one of them who would embody Jesus' proclamation of God's good news. After this, no one dares to challenge Jesus again with any more hostile questions. In closing, let's go pray. Lord God, open our hearts to your grace. Sustain us from human waywardness and selfishness. Keep us faithful to your word. May we love you with all our heart, mind, soul, and strength. May we love our neighbor as ourselves. Through our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you, and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forevermore. Amen. admonishing one another in all wisdom, singing psalms and hymns with spiritual songs, with thankfulness in your hearts to God. And whatever you do in word or deed, do everything in the name of the Lord Jesus, giving thanks to God the Father through him. Amen. Blessed are all who put their trust in the Lord. He will keep them in his presence and his peace. The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Let us bless the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
To the King of ages, immortal and invisible, the only God, be honour and glory forever and ever. Amen. Go in peace to love and serve the Lord.
In the name of Christ.
Amen.